Hi students, in this video we are going to discuss about the topic parallel languages and compiler in model 5. Let us go to the core topic. The language features for the parallel programming is divided into 6 categories according to the functionality. So these features are setting the guidelines for developing a user-friendly programming environment. What are those features? Those features are like optimization feature, availability feature, synchronization or communication features, and control of parallelism features, data parallelism feature, and process management features. Like that, these language features are divided into 6 categories according to the functionality. So let us see the features one by one in each. So these features are, first feature is optimization feature. So this feature is used for program restructuring and compilation in the sequentially coded programs. So what it will do means, these features are used for program restructuring and compilation in the sequential coded programs, and thus will be converted as in parallel forms. And the purpose of this feature is to convert the software parallelism with the hardware parallelism in target machines. So what are those means? There are some optimization features are there. The examples are automated parallelizer, semi-automatic parallelizers, interactive restructure support. So automatic parallelizer, and the examples are Express C automated parallelizers and the Alien FX Fortran compiler. And semi-automated parallelizers, it needs compiler directives or program instructions. And interactive restructure support, it has static analyzer, runtime static graph, and code translator for restructuring Fortran code. So these are the features are involved in optimization concept. Then availability features. So in the availability features will be that qualitative factor. So you discuss about the 3 important qualitative features. Those are called as scalability, compatibility, portability. We know the meaning of scalability. Scalability is a one feature which talks about the number of processors available independent of the hardware topology. So if the processor wants to be added, means how it will be added and in what extent it can be added. So this is given in scalability. And compatibility, the language should be compatible with the established language. So that is given in the compatibility feature. And portability, this language should be portable to all the shared memory multiprocessor or multi message passing multi computers. So it should be portable on both the things, shared memory multiprocessor and also message passing multi computers. So these are all about availability features. The third feature is synchronization or communication features. So here some features are given for synchronization or communication processes purposes. What are those means? Single assessment language. So the language should be single assignment, shared variables for IPC. It should support these features. So it should have remote procedure calls, and it should support data flow languages such as LD. It should have the sender receiving message passing technologies and logically shared memory such as the tuple space in Lynda. So these are all the synchronization and communication features. And the fourth feature is control of parallelism. So here also some of the features are listed. What are those means? First one is, it talks about the granularity. First feature is it tells about either the granularity is coarse, medium or fine. And also the second feature is about the explicit versus implicit parallelisms, and global parallelism also is covered here. So global parallelism in the entire program is given, and also loop parallelism in iterations wise. And when we speak about the task level, so the task dependency specification also one of the features of parallelism here. And move on to the fifth parallelism feature is called as the data parallelism feature. So here this is used to specify how data are accessed and distributed in either SIMD and MIMD computers. So here some of the features are given. What are those means? First one is runtime automated decomposition. Second one is mapping specification. Third one is virtual processor support. Fourth one is direct access to shared data. Fifth one is SPMD, that is single program multiple data. These are all the important features provided under the topic of data parallelisms. And sixth one, the last feature is process management feature. So this feature is mainly required to support the efficient creation of parallel processors and implementations of multi-threading, multitasking, program partitioning and replications. So what it contains, what are the features it is provided here means it provides the dynamic process creation at runtime, and it also supports the lightweight processes. Like say for example, threads are the best example for lightweight process, and it also supports the partitioned network in the sense, and the processes should be separated and should be analogously partitioned into number of clusterings. So these are called as partitioned networks. Automated load balancing. The workload is dynamically migrated among the different processing nodes to achieve the same amount of work at various processor nodes. So automatic load balancing is also another type of features which come under the topic of process management features. So likewise, we saw six different categories of features which are coming under parallel languages. The next topic is optimization compiler for parallelism. So what is the role of compiler here? So we know the meaning of compiler. It converts the high level languages into lower level languages. That means it converts the high level languages into in terms of source code. So what will happen if compiler is not there, or what is the important responsibility of compiler means? First of all, this compiler is removing the burden of program optimization and code generation from the programmer. So this it removes the burden of program optimization and code generation. Optimizing compiler is a compiler which tries to minimize or maximize some attributes of an executable computer program. So likewise, there are three levels of optimizing compiler are there. One is flow analysis, program optimization and parallel code generation. So these are called as three phases of a compiler. First one is flow analysis. What it will tell and what it contains means it contains the flow. Flow in the sense it may be data flow or it may be a program flow. So this it is mentioned in terms of patterns. So in this program flow pattern, in order to determine data and control dependencies in the source code. And also this is conducted at different levels of execution. So instruction level parallelism, we know that instruction level parallelism is exploited in superscalar and our VLSI processor, and loop level in SIMD. And optimization, the transformation of user program in order to explore the hardware capabilities is optimization. So this will be conducted at root level, locality level or prefetching levels. And third one is code generation. Code generation usually involves the transformation from high level into intermediate level. So here why it is most demanding means the parallel construct must be included in the instruction scheduling policies. So if this code generation encourages the high degree of parallelism, and this parallel code generation is very different to different. It will be varying in the different to different computer classes. They are software and hardware scheduled. I hope you understand this logic, and I'll catch you in the next video about the next topic. Thank you.